presidential library isn't like an ordinary library where you check out a book to read. It's a place where we historians do our most important research work. This is an archive where we preserve and study a collection of original letters, personal objects, photos, and papers about a president and his times.
The museum houses items like Abraham Lincoln's stovepipe hat with actual finger marks on it from where he would doff the hat as he greeted people each day. We have one of the few handwritten copies of the Gettysburg Address.
In Lincoln's own hand. And we here highly resolve that these dead shall not have died in vain. That this nation, under God, shall have a new birth of freedom, and the government of the people, by the people, for the people, shall not perish from the earth.
We've got a signed copy of the Emancipation Proclamation, and visitors can come here and tour the museum and see these items that really bring you up close and personal with Abraham Lincoln, so you have an actual chance to connect with him in a way that you can't anywhere else. And then in addition to the documents and the scholarship, we have cutting-edge technology that really tries to bring Abraham Lincoln to life.
Sometimes, in our imaginations, these people seem so real. If only we could meet them for a moment, ask them a question. But we can't. They're gone.
And then finally, we have the White House and taking you through his presidential years in a way that you won't find anywhere else in the world.
So, why save all this stuff? Because our past illuminates our future. It tells us we are a people who despise oppression and embrace freedom. And that we are willing to fight, and if need be, die for those ideals. I know. I died for those ideals that day in Vicksburg. That was my flag. Now, it's yours. As long as our story is told, our experience becomes your experience. Our courage becomes your courage. And the best part of us lives on in you.